I'm outside the water barrel, and this is not a documentary, and it's got nothing to do with water or barrel. In fact, this is a brand new alternative music college opening right in the center of Brighton. I met the really interesting people that opened the college with a different attitude and a very specific idea of what a college should look like.
It was rock and roll.
A water bear is a little creature. It's microscopic, and its defining characteristic is that it's indestructible. So that's what we want for the creative people that study courses at water bear. So that's the short story.
Someone says that water bear might be an alien.
There is a theory that they've come from space, but you can actually fire them at the sun and bring them back in a space shuttle, and they will survive. They can survive even being left in the Sahara Desert for 10 years. They're amazing.
Is this what's going to happen to this college?
It's not just the college, it's the people that study the college, because creatives have a real roller coaster career. And we want people to have the resilience and the flexibility to cope with that and have a lifetime in music.
One of the things I think about this place is that when I started out in the music industry, with the exception of a couple of people like Mark, there was this real feeling that you had to just go out there and learn it, and like the knowledge was a precious thing and people wouldn't share their knowledge of how it worked. And I was sort of proud of that fact for a while, and I think that was misplaced, because I was lucky. I know tons of musicians who are more talented than me and have more to say than me, who are not now full-time creative people, because they got chewed up and spat out by the whole thing. And actually, the world would be a better place if the people who have achieved some sort of privilege in the music world can try and share it and try and break down the barriers to entry. I think that's a good thing to do.
So my sort of job on a day-to-day basis is going to be making sure that the college is running, that students are having a great experience. I've got a long history with Bruce and with Adam. I've worked with them since 2002. I'm a musician myself. I went to visit Bruce when he was setting up colleges. And I really like the idea of supporting young musicians and helping them, because when I was younger, nobody helped me, and I've learned the very, very hard way, which took a long time. It cost a lot of money, and it wasn't enjoyable to begin with. So I always vowed to myself I would help, you know, up and coming musicians to make their careers, you know, and get them where they wanted to go.
Well, we've just finished the building. It's fairly echoey, as you can hear. So we're in a fresh new studio. There's a bit of sound work to do yet, but the desk has arrived. The gear's in. Reclaimed wood. We're really big on the mix with vintage and modern, so if you come this way, I think that's where a lot of exciting music is made these days, the kind of intersection between doing things in a traditional way and then twisting it around. So there's a lot of old vintage Valvi gear in here, but also we've got heaps of very up-to-date software, so you know, like I say, it's that kind of expensive analogue thing we like, sort of expensive lo-fi.
I had the feelings in interviewing the other guys, especially Bruce, that this is a very analogue-based mentality college.
Yeah.
In many ways.
Yeah.
Is this like a revival of the vinyl kind of college?
A vinyl college. Yeah. I do think that one of the things that they're doing here, which is really good, is they're combining two separate approaches to learning in a way that not many places, other places that I know of, are doing, which is, you know, they're encouraging a lot of sort of home activity, and on the one hand, and, you know, teaching yourself, which is how a lot of people do it or did it or whatever, but also the sort of one-on-one mentoring situations, which is what I'm going to be doing some of over time when my tour schedule allows, you know, which is also vital.
We've got a very flexible approach, so the way we study music is a lot of the lectures are done online, and then when we come together, we're here to discuss the concepts. So it is higher education, so it is masters, and it is the sort of higher end of degree level. So we're not here learning scales, because people can do that on YouTube, you know. So that's why it looks like this, because it's about discussion and debate. And I think the days of a lecturer standing in front of rows of seats and telling people how it is kind of over now, because we can all just Google it and check what he's saying or she's saying. So we've all got a lot of information, but the important thing that I think young creatives need, actually creatives of any age, it's one-to-one mentoring, because we've all got slightly different ways that we organise essentially a self-employed career, and that kind of strategic approach, how you organise your income streams and survive through change, that's what it's all about.
This is alternative because it's very much focusing on the individual. So we are very keen on one-to-one tutorials and very small group sizes. So it's kind of, we want to build a community. So we know every student, we know where every student wants to go, you know, and we're kind of we're almost like family, which is why it's different. So it's very small.
It's art and craft, and it's, you know, it's your artistic outfit. But I think these days, for most of us, we also have to understand business. We also have to produce content. You know, we all have to be experts at digital marketing. We all have to record and mix and master our own music. And within that, we also have to have our own creative output out there and stand for something. You know? So there's an awful lot of responsibilities for an artist these days. But if you can get that right, the reward of all that work, because that's what it is really, is work, the reward is a long-term career in music, and no one can ever take it away from you.
So what else is here? Do you want to show me anything?
Yeah. So this is a general sort of teaching room. We do a lot of guitar stuff in here. The guitar course we run in association with Rob Chapman, who's a big YouTube guitar player. So it's bang up to date. So we've got a load of old amps that have stood the test of time. We've bought a load of new gear from a company called Victory. This is a British company. These amps are made in the UK. Very sort of, they're suitable for kind of modern, very modern players. And then flying the flag for the traditional stuff is another amp that's made in the UK. You'll see lots of these Cornells, hand-wired and hand-built in Essex. Seems to be an awful lot of amps and musical equipment made in Essex. We still use a blackboard. We project over there onto the screen. So we, again, it's this kind of sense of some stuff that we've done for centuries still works, you know. And there's a Fender Strat up there. Essentially, that's the same guitar you could have bought in 1954, you know, and it still sounds great.
What was your ideal student? The perfect student that's going to come out of this college?
I think the ideal student is somebody who's better at all of it than I am, and there will be loads of them. I love being around young creative people because one of the most exciting moments in any creative person's artistic life is when they are first getting to grips with the tools and the language of the art that they're trying to make, because everybody spews out something weird and unique at the beginning, because that's your character is sort of unformed. You know, that's the reason why a lot of bands' debut albums are really exciting, is because no one's told them they're not allowed to do that. You know, and I hope that that will be one of the spirits of here, is no one saying no to anything, really. Do you know what I mean? So I my ideal student would be somebody who shocks and surprises me and knows something that I don't know.
So here, there's a succession of little tutorial rooms and small groups where, because this one-to-one mentoring is so important. And most of the time, when people talk, we'll ask you about specific guitar or vocal technique or songwriting stuff. But actually, because we're covering so much of that online and in the classroom, what people generally need help with is career planning. So that's the discussions. Most of the discussions are about, okay, I'm here now, I want to be here, what's the path, what are the steps, what can I do this week, what can I do this month, and what are my plans for the year and 5 years, you know. And we love that stuff, you know, because then you can make a desire to work in music a reality rather than a pipe dream. Everybody's welcome, but the people that we accept on the course, either on degree or masters, they've already got stuff going on, so we help them grow that. So it's not the place to come if you've just got a guitar for Christmas, and you know, there's some great YouTube guys out there that could help you with your early days songwriting, your bands, and all the rest of it. But when you've got something going and you want to do a music degree, and music's a very important part of your life, and you're prepared to do the work, and if you've got something going on and you've got drive and energy, then we want to hear about it. And we love new music. We love it if it's a bit primitive, that's fine. At master's level, something very exciting there is we help people who've got very established careers come in and kind of write that up and gain a master's qualification for the work they've already done. And that's very exciting. For people who are at earlier stages in their career, that's why we do a lot of YouTube and Facebook content to help people. And we feel that knowledge is free. So we give that out just to stimulate the scene, and we run various festival stages and all sorts of stuff to generate the scene. You know.